Welcome to Unfold Data Science. This is Aman here and I am a data scientist. In this video, we are going to understand neural network in simple steps. So neural network typically sounds little mathematical and little deep topic to understand. But in this video, I am going to show you by taking a small data set, how can you implement your first neural network in very simple and easy steps. Okay. So first step, what I am doing, I am importing the packages. Now all these packages you must be aware of except these two packages. So if you see, I am importing from Keras.models import sequential. So first of all, what is Keras? Keras is basically a framework in Python that allows you to implement neural network models. Okay. And from Keras.models, I am importing sequential. I'll tell you what is this. And from Keras.layers, I am importing dense. I'm going to tell you what are these things. Okay. Before that, if you want to go to Keras documentation, I have given the link here. You can go and read more about this particular package. Okay. Now moving on to our data. What is the data we are talking about here? We are talking about a diabetes data set. Okay. So let me read the data again. And here, if you can see the first few rows of the data, you can see there are pregnancies, how many times somebody was pregnant, what is the blood glucose level, blood pressure, skin thickness, insulin. So based on these numbers or these features of a patient, the training data is there, which tells whether a person is diabetic or not diabetic. Okay. So 0 stands for non-diabetic, 1 stands for diabetic. Now in this data, the objective is to predict based on diagnostic measurement whether a person has diabetes or does not have diabetes. So this is basically a classification problem, okay, which we will solve using a neural network model. Moving on to the next step. So we have to see what is the target variable distribution, right? So how many people are diabetic and how many people are not diabetic. So that's what I'm seeing in the data. Close to 500 people have no diabetes and some 250 odd people have diabetes. Okay. Now moving on to the data, preparing data for modeling. So these steps you must be aware of this. So I'm just taking first, you know, apart from response, everything else in the predictor and the response in the response variable, right? So response is nothing but the 0-1 column that we saw above. I'm splitting the data in test and train. There is no brainer here. You would have seen this so many times. I am splitting in 20-20-80 ratio, right? Now comes the very important part of this video, okay? So training the neural network model, I have knowingly kept the data very simple so that it's easier for you to grasp the neural network concept. Okay. Now there are two ways to build Keras model. One is known as sequential and other is known as functional. What is the difference? A sequential model or a sequential way allows you to create model layer by layer. So if you remember, we discussed how we can create layers of a neural network. So I have shown you all the things in my theoretical videos where I explained this is how hidden layer looks like, this is how output layer looks like, this is how activation function, this is what is the weights, bias, those things. All those things we will define in this block of code, okay? This block of code is very, very important here, okay? So what I am doing in the very first line, I am initializing a sequential Keras model. So I am calling this model as a sequential model. Okay. So I had imported sequential in the beginning, if you remember. So initializing model, and what I am doing next is Keras model dot add. I want to add one layer to this initialized model. Okay. What kind of layer? Dense layer. What is the meaning of dense layer? The meaning of dense layer is it is a fully connected neural network. Understand these things very well, guys. These are very important. I have initialized the model here, sequential model, and this is my first hidden layer in the model. So what is my first hidden layer saying? It says, give me a dense model that has 12 neurons and expect 8 dimensions in input. So why 8 dimensions? Because we have 8 independent columns in the data. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many input features we have in the model? 8. That is why we are saying to the first hidden layer, create 12 neurons and expect 8 dimensions in input and put the ReLU as an activation function. Why ReLU? I just want to avoid the exploding and vanishing gradient problem. This is about first hidden layer. Let us define the second hidden layer. In my second hidden layer, I am saying Keras model.add again a fully connected network I want to create, so dense. And then no need to give input dimension here, because input dimension is needed in the first hidden layer only, right? So here how many neurons we want? 8 neurons. This is the unit size. So how many neurons you want? 8 neurons. Activation function ReLU. This is about your second hidden layer. Okay. Now two hidden layers we have built in this network. So what is the third thing here? This is nothing but your output layer. So in our output layer, how many neurons you want? Since this is a classification problem, so the output has to be in terms of probabilities, or it has to be in the terms of values like 0 or 1, right? So only one neuron will do the job. That is why I am saying in output layer, give me one neuron, apply the sigmoid activation function. Why sigmoid? Because sigmoid is useful for the classification problems. If you remember how sigmoid works, then this you will understand why we have used sigmoid, because it will always give you 0 or 1 as an input, right? Now this is what we have put here, okay? So it is very important to understand what is happening in this block. In this entire script, this block is very, very important. If you have any doubts on this block, write me in the comment, okay? So we have defined our Keras model. Now what? Now we have to compile the model. Compile means we have to just keep the model ready to consume the data, right? I am saying Keras model.compile. We have to define a loss function here. In this case, I am saying binary underscore cross entropy. So in my theoretical videos, I have not specifically explained what is binary cross entropy. I will do that. This is one of the loss function that you assume for now. Okay. Optimizer is equal to Adam. So there are different optimizers in neural network. In this case, I am taking Adam. So different optimizers also will be there in my playlist. Don't worry for that. Okay. So this is one of the optimizer. What matrix we want the model to consider? Accuracy. So we can consider other matrices as well. Let us compile this model and let us run this model. So I'm running this model now. As you can see, the message is printing epoch 1 by 150. So how many epochs we are running here? 150 epochs. So I have explained you in the theory what is epoch, right? I have explained you the batch size. Batch size is nothing but how many observations to consider in one epoch, okay? And then X trend and Y trend that we created above goes as the input to the Keras model. Okay. If you can see, guys, as I told you, in every epoch, weights and biases will get adjusted and the model's accuracy will improve. And if you see here, it started from 0.77. And let us see what is the after it starts adjusting the model, how much it can reach. So at some places it will decrease also. Some places it might increase a little bit, some places it might decrease a little bit. The reason for that is weight adjustment is happening in the background, okay? So which weight is best for this model, that is what Keras model will give in the end, okay? So if we come here, then we can see that the model 150 iterations have been completed and we have some accuracy numbers in front of us. So out of all these, whatever is the best accuracy, that will be taken by the Keras model, okay? So 150 epochs or 150 iterations have been run. Now coming here, let us see what is the train accuracy. So our train accuracy is 78.66. So if you remember, in the first epoch, the model started from somewhere around 77, right? And model, after doing the weight adjustment, going back and forth, model is able to give us 78% of accuracy on training data. Okay. So that is what model has done internally in various epochs. What is the accuracy on test? Accuracy on test is, last time when I ran it was 74, now it is 75%. That's good. So what we have done from beginning to end, we have just defined Keras model. And this is the very important part of this code. As I told you, how do you define different layers in your Keras, right? And then I'm calling that Keras and getting an accuracy of 76 and 78% in test and train. Now, in my opinion, I will not tell you if this model is good or not good. I want you to comment me. Can you say this is a good model? If yes, how? And if no, why? I mean, if your view is yes, then why your view is yes? If your view is no, then why your view is no? You have to write me in comment. And also, if you have some idea on improving the accuracy of the model. So write me in comment your queries. I'll come up with another interesting video. All of you, till then, stay safe and take care.